In this video, we will see how we can shift multiple columns in the dataset in one go. Normally, to shift a column, we select the column, press shift, we'll keep the shift key pressed, drag and drop the column wherever we need. It is easy to shift one or two columns, but what if we have to shift multiple columns in the dataset? Let's see how we can do this. We have a dataset here which has 5000 rows and multiple columns like employee ID, full name, job title, department, and so on. I need to rearrange the columns as per my requirement. Say I need gender column after full name and then age. Then I need the business unit. After business unit, I need department. After department, I need job title. So before we shift the columns, we'll copy the headers in other sheet so that later on, when we move the columns, we can compare them. So we'll select the columns, we'll select the headers, copy, and make one more sheet. Right click, and I'll click on transpose. So we have the headers here. Now to rearrange the columns, we'll add one more row before the headers and we'll assign the numbers to the columns to rearrange them. So I need employee ID should be the first column, so I'll just put it 1. I'll assign the number as 1 to this column. Full name will be on the second position. After full name, I need gender, so that will be the third column. For age, it will be fourth column. Country will be the fifth column. City will be the sixth column. After city, I need business unit, that will be the seventh column. Department as eighth column. Job title as ninth column. Then the annual salary will be the 10th column. Bonus will be the 11th column. Hire date, that will be the 12th column. And at the end, I need exit date as the 13th column. So we have assigned the numbers to the columns. Once you have assigned that, we'll select the data. So we'll just press Ctrl A. We'll go to data tab and click on sort. In the sort window, we'll click on options. We'll select sort left to right, click OK. And in sort by, we'll select row 1 because row 1 has the numbers which we have assigned to the columns. And you click OK. So once you click OK, you will see that all the columns has been rearranged as per the numbers we had given to the or assigned to the columns. So let's just copy the headers once again and we'll paste it here in the transpose mode. And you will see that the headers which were there earlier has been rearranged to the headers as we needed as per the requirement. So employee ID was the same, full name was the same, the third position was job title, but we have shifted gender on the third position. Fourth position was department, we have shifted age. Fifth was business unit, we have shifted country, and so on. So that is how we can shift multiple columns if you have large data very easily by assigning the numbers to the columns. Let me show you one more trick. So I have some employee names here in these two columns, and if you see, I have added the bullets before the names. So we have a dot here in this column and we have an arrow here in this column. I have to enter products here in this column, but I don't want to enter the bullets manually. What I want is whenever I enter the product name should be auto prefixed with a bullet whenever I type and press enter. So let's see how we can do that. We'll select the columns or the cells. Before that, we just need to get the bullet. So we'll go to Insert, go to Symbol. You can select any of the symbol whichever you want. So I'll just select the arrow. I'll click Insert and Close. We'll copy this bullet. Select the cells where you want this particular bullet to be prefixed whenever you enter the data and press Enter. Now we'll press Ctrl 1, click on Custom. We'll delete this general, paste the bullet which we had copied here. After the bullet, we'll press @ or we'll type the @ and click OK. Now let's see, once we enter the product name, whether it gets prefixed by the bullet automatically. So I'll just enter like Lenovo and I press Enter. You will see that it gets prefixed by the bullet. That is how we can automatically add the bullets without typing it manually whenever we want to add bullets in front of the or before the names. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do give it a thumbs up. Do subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet. I'll catch you in the next video.